Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. So we are discussing second law of thermodynamics, module 3, and this is the 9th lecture on the second law of thermodynamics. So we recap from the previous lecture. We discussed the Clausius inequality. So based on that, we can classify the process whether this is a reversible cycle or irreversible process or a impossible process. And we defined the entropy and entropy calculation for various processes. And in this lecture, we will be solving few problems on the concept what we discussed in the earlier lecture. And the learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems on entropy of a process. We take the first example from the anonymity question paper, May 2017. 300 kgs per second of heat is supplied at a constant fixed temperature of 290 degrees Celsius to a heat engine. The heat rejection takes place at 8.5 degrees Celsius. The following results were obtained. 1. 215 closures per second are rejected. 2. 150 closures per second are rejected. 3. 75 closures per second are rejected. Classify which of the results report reversible cycle or irreversible cycle or impossible cycle. So you write down the given data. So the amount of heat supplied Q1 equal to 300 closures per second. And the corresponding temperature equal to 290 degrees Celsius, which is 563 Kelvin. The temperature at which heat rejected is 8.5 degrees Celsius, which is 281.5 Kelvin. Now we take the first case, heat rejected Q2 equal to 215 kilojoules per second. So the based on the Clausius inequality, the cyclic integral of del Q by T. We have to calculate cyclic integral of del Q by T, so which is equal to Q1 by T1 minus Q2 by T2. So Q1 is the amount of heat supplied divided by the corresponding temperature minus Q2 divided by the corresponding temperature T2. So substitute numerical values 300 divided by 563 minus 215 divided by 281.5 equal to minus of 0.231, which is less than 0. So the cycle is irreversible. So for a irreversible cycle, cyclic integral of del Q by T less than 0. We take the second case, heat rejected Q2 equal to 150 kilojoules per second. Again the same equation, cyclic integral of del Q by T equal to Q1 by T1 minus Q2 by T2 equal to substituting numerical value is 300 divided by 563 minus 150 divided by 281.5 equal to 0. So the cycle is reversible. When del Q, cyclic integral of del Q by T equal to 0, the cycle is reversible. And third case, the heat rejected Q2 equal to 75 kilojoules per second. Again, we take the same formula, the cyclic integral of del Q by T equal to Q1 by T1 minus Q2 by T2, which is 300 divided by 563 minus 75 divided by 281.5. which is 0.266, which is greater than 0, the cycle is impossible. So the problem is from the Clausius inequality. So when the cyclic integral of del Q by T is greater than 0, the cycle is impossible. The cyclic integral of del Q by T equal to 0, the cycle is reversible. And so when del Q by T, cyclic integral of del Q by T is less than 0, the cycle is irreversible. And we take the example 2 from the May 2017 question paper. A quantity of air undergoes a thermodynamic cycle consisting of three processes. Process 1 to 2, a constant volume heating from pressure P1 equal to 0.1 megapascal, temperature T1 equal to 15 degrees Celsius, volume V1 equal to 0.02 meter cube, to a pressure of P2 equal to 0.42 megapascal. Process 2 to 3 is constant pressure cooling. Process 3 to 1 is isothermal heating to the initial state. Employing ideal gas model, Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram. Evaluate the change in entropy of each process. Sketch the cycle on the PV and TS coordinates. the given data. So initial pressure P1 equal to 0.1 megapascal, T1 equal to 15 degree Celsius, V1 equal to volume equal to 0.02 meter cube, pressure P2 equal to 0.42 megapascal, Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So we take R equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So Cv equal to 0.713 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So Cv equal to Cp minus R. And the PV and TS diagram. So 1 to 2 process constant volume heating, 2 to 3 constant pressure cooling, and 3 to 1 it is constant temperature heating. So this is the pressure volume and temperature entropy diagram for the thermodynamic cycle. And we have V1 equal to V2 for constant volume process, V1 equal to U2, V2 for constant pressure process, P2 equal to P3, and for constant temperature process, T1 equal to T3. So these are all the conditions for the cycle. So the mass of the gas M equal to P1 V1 divided by RT1. So from the perfect gas equation, we calculate P1 equal to 0.1 into 1000. So 0.1 megapascal, it is given as 0.1 megapascal into 1000 into V1 equal to 0.02 divided by R equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and temperature in Kelvin 15 plus 273. So calculating mass of the air equal to 0.024 kilogram. Now the change in entropy for the constant volume heating process. So 1 to 2 is constant volume heating process. So S2 minus S1 equal to MCV into logarithmic of P2 by P1, which is 0.024 into 0.713 into logarithmic of 0.42 divided by 0.1 equal to 0.0245 kilojoules per Kelvin. And for the constant volume process, the temperature, final temperature T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1. So 288 into 0.42 divided by 0.1 equal to 1209.6 Kelvin. So the temperature after constant volume heating equal to 1209.6 Kelvin. And the change in entropy for the process 2 to 3 constant pressure cooling. So S3 minus S2 equal to MCP into T3 by T2. T3 by T2 equal to 0.024 into 1 into logarithmic of 288 divided by 1209.6 equal to minus of 0.0344 kilojoules per Kelvin. So this constant process, cooling process. So for cooling process, heat is rejected, so the entropy change is negative. For constant volume process, heat is added, it is a heating process, so the entropy change is positive. And for the third process, entropy change for 3 to 1 isothermal heating, S3 minus S1 equal to MR into logarithmic of P3 by P1, which is equal to 0.024 into 0.287 into logarithmic of 0.42 divided by 0.1, which is 0.0099 kilojoules per Kelvin. So the three processes, we have calculated the change in entropy. We take the third example, air with a mass of 6 kilograms expands isothermally from 1.2 meter cube to 5 meter cube. Compute the change in entropy of air during the process. Assume air to be an ideal gas with a constant specific heat. So this is from the question paper, unanimous question paper, November 2012. So we write down the given data. So M equal to 6 kg, V1 velocity, volume V1 equal to 1.2 meter cube, volume final volume V2 equal to 5 meter cube. We take R for the air as 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So the change in entropy for isothermal process, S2 minus S1 equal to MR into logarithmic of V2 by V1, which is equal to 6 into 0.287 into logarithmic of 5 divided by 1.2, which is 2.46 kilojoules per Kelvin. So this is the answer to the problem. The change in entropy of the isothermal process, 2.46 kilojoules per Kelvin. Then we take the fourth example. From the anionic question paper, May 2017, an iron cube at a temperature of 400 degrees Celsius is dropped into an insulated bath containing 10 kg of water at 25 degrees Celsius. The water finally reaches the temperature of 50 degrees Celsius at the steady state. Given that the specific heat of water is equal to 4186 joules per kilogram Kelvin, find the entropy change of the iron cube and the water. So the temperature of the iron cube, initial temperature of the iron cube is 400 degrees Celsius. Mass of the water equal to 10 kilogram. Initial temperature of water is 25 degrees Celsius. Final temperature of water is final temperature after equilibrium, both the temperature will become equal. So thermal equilibrium TW, water final temperature and the iron cube final temperature equal to 50 degrees Celsius, and the specific heat of water equal to 4186 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Now the heat lost by the iron cube. So the iron cube is at a higher temperature, initially 400 degrees Celsius, finally 50 degrees Celsius. It is losing its heat energy. Water initially 25 degrees Celsius and finally it is 50 degrees Celsius. It is gaining the water. So heat lost by the iron cube equal to heat gained by the water. So mc into T1i minus T2i equal to mwcpw into T2w minus T1w. So MICI is the unknown. So mass of the iron cube is not known and specific heat also not known. So MICI is the unknown into 400 minus 50 equal to 10 into 4186 into 50 minus 25. So solving the product MICI equal to 2990 joules per Kelvin. So the entropy change of the iron cube. So delta S equal to MICI into logarithmic of final temperature divided by the initial temperature. T2i divided by T1i. So 2990 into logarithmic of 50 plus 273 divided by 400 plus 273 equal to minus of 2194.9 joules per Kelvin. Then the entropy change of water delta S equal to MWCPW into logarithmic of T2W divided by T1W, so which is 10 into 4186 into logarithmic of 50 plus 273 divided by 25 plus 273 equal to 3372.2 joules per Kelvin. So net change of entropy, they add these two values, 3372.2 minus 2194.9 equal to 1173.3 joules per Kelvin. So delta S is greater than 0, so the process is irreversible. So the fifth problem from the unanswered question paper, November 2016, a 30 kg iron block and a 40 kg copper block, both initial at 80 degrees Celsius, are dropped into a lake at 15 degrees Celsius. Thermal equilibrium is established after a while as a result of heat transfer between block and lake water. Determine the total entropy change of this process. This is from November 2016 question paper. So the mass of the iron block, Mi equal to 30 kilogram, mass of the copper block MC equal to 40 kilogram, T1 initial temperature is 80 degrees Celsius and the final temperature is 15 degrees Celsius. So you take the specific heat of iron block, iron material is 0.462 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and specific heat of copper equal to 0.385 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And these two are constants we have to take from the thermal property table. So entropy change of the iron block, so delta is I equal to MICI into logarithmic of T2 by T1, which is 30 into 0.462 into logarithmic of 15 plus 273 divided by 80 plus 273, which is minus of 2.82 kilojoules per Kelvin. And the entropy change of the copper block, delta SC equal to MCCC into logarithmic of T2 by T1, which is 40 into 0.385 into logarithmic of 15 plus 273 divided by 80 plus 273 equal to minus of 3.13 kilojoules per Kelvin. And the heat given to the water. So the copper block and the iron block both are cooled. So the amount of heat given to the water equal to the mass of the two blocks MICI plus MCCC into temperature difference T2 minus T1. So the amount of heat given to the water is 1901.9 kilojoules. So the entropy change of water equal to delta SW equal to Q by T, which is 1901.9 divided by 288 equal to 6.6 kilojoules per Kelvin. So this is the change in entropy of the water and the change in entropy of the iron cube and the copper cube we have already calculated. So the total entropy change delta S equal to SI plus SC delta SC plus S delta SW equal to minus of 2.82 minus of 3.313 plus 6.6 equal to 0.65 kilojoules per Kelvin. That is the answer, final answer. And example number 6 from the Anna University question paper, May 2016 and November 2012. A metal block with mass equal to 5 kg, specific heat equal to 0.4 kJ per kilogram Kelvin at 40 degree Celsius is kept in a room at 20 degree Celsius. It is cooled in the following two ways. One, using the Carnot engine with the room itself as a cold reservoir, with the room itself as a cold reservoir. Two, naturally. In each case, calculate the change in entropy of the block, change in entropy of the air, and change in entropy of the universe. Assume the metal block has constant specific heat. So, the given data, mass of the metal block equal to 5 kg, specific heat of the metal block equal to 0.4 kJ per kilogram Kelvin, initial temperature is 40 degree Celsius, and final temperature is 20 degree Celsius. So, it is a large room. So, room is acting as a, the air in the room is acting as a sink. So, there won't be any change in the temperature of the sink. So, using the Carnot engine with the room itself as a cold reservoir. So, heat lost by the block equal to heat gained by the water. So, the amount of heat transfer between the block and the air. So, Q equal to MC into T2 minus T1. So, 5 into 0.4 into 40 minus 20 equal to 40 kilojoules. So, the amount of heat transfer between the metal block and the air, it is 40 kilojoules. Now, the energy entropy change on the metal block, so delta SM equal to minus Q by T1. So, why this negative? The negative sign is due to the metal block loses its heat energy, so there will be entropy decrease. So, minus Q by T1 equal to minus of 40 divided by 313 equal to minus 0.128 kilojoules per Kelvin. The entropy change of air, delta SA equal to Q by T2, which is equal to 40 divided by 293 equal to 0.136 kilojoules per Kelvin. And the entropy change of the universe, delta S equal to delta S of the metal, change in entropy of the metal, plus change in entropy of the air, delta SA equal to minus of 0.128 plus 0.136 equal to 0.008 kilojoules per Kelvin. So, when the process occurs naturally, the entropy change for the metal block, delta SM equal to MC into logarithmic of T2 by T1, which is 5 into 0.4 into logarithmic of 293 divided by 313 equal to minus of 0.132 kilojoules per Kelvin, and the entropy change of air equal to 0 because air temperature does not change, and the entropy change of universe delta S equal to delta SM plus delta SA equal to minus of 0.132 plus 0 equal to minus of 0.132 kilojoules per Kelvin. We take example number 7. A fluid undergoes reversible adiabatic compression from 4 bar 0.3 meter cube to 0.08 meter cube. According to the law, PV to the power 1.25 equal to constant. Determine the change in enthalpy, change in internal energy, and change in entropy of the compression process. So, this is from the Anna University question paper, November 2018. Now, the given data, P1 equal to 4 bar, volume V1 equal to 0.3 meter cube, final volume V2 equal to 0.08 meter cube, and the polytropic index N equal to 1.25. So, the final pressure of the fluid, so P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power N, which is 4 into 0.3 divided by 0.08 to the power 1.25 equal to 20.87 bar. That is the pressure. And change in entropy for the adiabatic process equal to 0. And the change in enthalpy for the process dH equal to VdP. So, dH integrating this equation, left hand side H2 minus H1 equal to integrate VdP. So, the V volume is in terms of P1 V1 to the power n divided by P. So, P1 V1 to the power n equal to constant. And P is variable, so to the power 1 by n. So, rearranging H2 minus H1 equal to P1 V1 to the power n to the power 1 by n is a constant. So, P1 V1 to the power n to the power 1 by n integral dP by P to the power 1 by n. Now, the P to the power 1 by n will go to the numerator, integrating P to the power minus 1 by n with respect to pressure. So, H2 minus H1 equal to P1 V1 to the power n to the power 1 by n. Into P1 to the power minus 1 by n plus 1 divided by minus 1 by n plus 1 and within the limit 1 and 2 and H2 minus H1 equal to, so this denominator, So it's a constant. Minus 1 by n plus 1 equal to, it will come to the numerator, n by n minus 1. So p1 v1 to the power n into to the power 1 by n into substituting the upper limit p2 to the power minus 1 by n plus 1 minus p1 to the power minus 1 by n plus 1. So now we take this value to, into the bracket and simplifying. So h2 minus h1 equal to n by n minus 1 into p2 v2 minus p1 v1. So enthalpy change equal to 1.25 divided by 1.25 minus 1 into 20.87 into 100. So the 20.87 is in bar into 100 to convert into kilopascal. So 100 into 0.08 minus 400 into 0.3. So calculating the change in enthalpy equal to 234.8 kilojoules. And the change in internal energy. So U2 minus U1 equal to H2 minus H1 minus of P2 V2 minus P1 V1. So 234.8 minus 20.87 into 100 into 0.08 minus 400 into 0.3 equal to 187.84 kilojoules. There is change in the internal energy. Then eighth problem, 50 kg of water at 313 Kelvin and enough ice at minus 5 degrees Celsius is mixed with water in an adiabatic vessel such that end of the process all the ice melts and water is at 0 degrees Celsius is obtained. Find the mass of the ice required and the entropy change of water and ice. So given that specific heat of water equal to 4.2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and specific heat of ice equal to 2.1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and the latent heat of ice equal to 335 kilojoules per Kelvin. So the process is we have 50 kg of water at a temperature of 313 Kelvin and we have certain quantity of ice at a temperature minus 5 degrees Celsius. They are mixed together and the final temperature become 0 degree Celsius. So the given data, mass of the water is 50 kilogram, temperature of water at initially 313 Kelvin, temperature of ice initially minus 5 degrees Celsius, which is 268 Kelvin, and the final temperature is 0 degrees Celsius, which is 273 Kelvin. Specific heat of water is 4.2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, specific heat of ice equal to 2.1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and latent heat of ice equal to 335 kilojoules per Kelvin. So heat gained by the water is equal to heat lost by the ice. So MW CPW into TW1 minus T2 equal to MI mass of the ice into CP of the ice into T2 minus T1 ice plus mass of the ice into latent heat of ice. So first ice, it is heated, actually the process will go like this, minus 5 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius, then it is cooled to water at melted to water into ice into water. So the latent heat is also playing here because we are converting ice into water. So ice is converted from minus 5 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. Then the ice at 0 degrees Celsius is converted into water at 0 degrees Celsius. So for the conversion of, for heating the ice from minus 5 degrees Celsius to the 0 degrees Celsius, this is the first term. Then the MI into LI is latent heat of ice is for converting ice at 0 degree Celsius into water at 0 degree Celsius. So substituting the values, 50 into 4.2 into 313 minus 273 equal to MI into 2.1, specific heat of ice equal to 2.1 into 273 minus 268 plus MI into 335. So solving this equation, we'll get the mass of the ice equal to MI equal to 24.31 kilogram. Then change in enthalpy of water, delta SW equal to MW CPW into logarithmic of T2 by T1W, which is 50 into 4.2 into logarithmic of 273 divided by 313 equal to minus of 28.7 kilojoules per Kelvin. And change in enthalpy of ice equal to delta S ice equal to MI CPI. CP ice into logarithmic of T2 by T1 ice into MI LI, latent heat of ice divided by the temperature of the ice. So 2431, that is the mass of the ice into 2.1 into logarithmic of 273 divided by 268 plus mass of the ice equal to 24.31 into 335 divided by 268. So the answer entropy change of the ice equal to 31.3 kilojoules per Kelvin. And these are all the reference books I used for preparing the slides. So you can also refer to it for additional information. And you can write to me to my mail ID for any queries or clarification or doubt. I will answer to your queries. So thank you for watching and we'll meet again.